Hello, Simmers.
Hello.
It is Sim Guru Ryan here, along with Sim Guru Houts.
Hello.
And welcome to today's Sims 4 live broadcast here on Twitch. We are thrilled today to give you a completely unscripted, uncanned, totally off-the-cuff demo of The Sims 4, because in less than 7 days, you guys are going to have The Sims 4 in your hands. Can you believe it?
It's pretty crazy.
It's unreal for me. We've been working on this game for a long time, and the fact that it launches in less than a week is kind of blowing my mind right now.
To see all the effort and just work we put into this about to come out to the world is pretty awesome.
It's pretty intense. Yeah. So to celebrate, we're going to be broadcasting every day through launch and into next week, just doing fun demos here on Twitch. We're going to be playing the game. Scripted PR, marketing messaging, just fun, just playing the game. And today, we thought we'd start with Create a Sim. No, wait, we're not going to play Create a Sim. You guys have been playing Create a Sim for the last couple weeks now.
We have so many Sims uploaded on the gallery now.
It is so much fun to see all of them. So we're gonna go straight past Create a Sim and jump right into build mode. And it just so happens that Aaron here was the designer on the feature. So you guys are going to get the inside scoop on all the best parts of build mode for The Sims 4. So I guess without further ado, why don't we jump straight into the game?
Yeah, let's hop in.
Okay.
That's what we set up for us here.
There we go. So we are in Oasis Springs, one of the beautiful new worlds here in The Sims 4. And we're already in build mode, and I think we're ready to just jump in.
I think so. We got this nice blank lot here. We can just build stuff up.
Yeah.
What's going on down here?
You know what, Aaron?
What did you do?
That sim looks familiar. Who is that? Started it with your sim. I think Sim Guru Jill actually uploaded you in addition to the other creative tools producers and designers. So you guys can actually go find Aaron on the gallery right now if you have the Create a Sim demo.
Uh-oh.
Be careful. Be careful. Let's just jump in, Aaron. Why don't you start showing us some of the cool new stuff about build mode in The Sims 4?
All right.
You know, I've been told it's really tactile and intuitive. Is that
true?
It
is so tactile and so intuitive.
I think we should do like a hashtag every time and people will turn it into a drinking game.
It'll get really crazy really fast.
Yeah, exactly.
But it is really awesome. It's really easy to just get in and play with it. So let's start doing that.
Yeah.
You know, actually, first things first, if I'm building a cool pad for my sim here, I think I'm going to need some more cash.
That's true.
So why don't we do our classic
one of the classic
here.
Cheats here. Why don't we give us a little mother load action? There we go. How many simoleons do you want, Aaron?
Give me that. Give me that a few more times.
Oops.
We gotta get the.
There we go.
Back up there.
Mother load.
I think do it like two more times.
Okay.
I'm going big on this.
Everybody's gonna count my typing per second here.
There we go.
There we go. Excellent. All right,
that's a good start.
Excellent.
Okay. Well, if we're just going to hop in, one of the easiest, coolest ways we can do this is I'm just going to take us straight to our styled rooms.
I love this feature.
Yeah, this is really great. We're really excited to get this in. So this is, you guys maybe have seen some of this before in some of our previews, but this is a bunch of pre-made, pre-styled rooms that we can go through for all these different categories. And you know, my sim's going to need a place to sleep.
Absolutely.
So let's check out the bedrooms here.
Mod Pod.
And you can see we've got everything from the very simple to maybe something a little more, that's not quite my style. Kind of like this. It's got this like Southwestern kind of flair to it.
It kind of fits the world we're playing in too.
It does, exactly.
Christmas touch.
But I think I want to change up the colors a little bit, see what else is available.
Excellent.
I like that dark hardwood floor.
I like it.
Some
American oak, some rich mahogany, perhaps.
Yes, very rich, very mahogany. All right. I'm just going to buy this room, and you can see it's just going to plop it right out into the world for me, and I can move it around. You know, I don't want my bedroom to be too close to the street, so let's start off back here, and I'm just going to drop that in.
Nice.
Let's take a closer look here for a sec. Yeah, this is looking pretty nice.
So now, Aaron, why don't you show them how you can make the adjustments? Because I think this is really one of the greatest parts about this mode. We had blueprint mode in The Sims 3, but this really takes it to the next level, being able to put it in, and then I think you can actually even just pick it right back up, right? And
yeah, sure. Around. Yeah, let me just zoom out a sec there. Yeah, I can say, you know what? I don't want the room there. I want it over here. I can rotate it around.
Excellent.
I think I actually like that original rotation, for now at least.
How about those three little dashes on top there?
What are these?
I don't know.
You know what? I want If I want shorter walls, I can do that. But you know what? I want nice tall first floor.
I wish there was a way for me to look back and find out when like the first request in all of Sims history for different size walls came through.
It would be years and years.
I'd imagine it was around 14 to 15 years ago when it first launched.
Yeah, probably. I think it's one of the things people wanted.
So thankfully, we have finally got it in the game.
Absolutely. So, very easy to adjust the wall heights, but also, this bedroom might get a little cramped. So I can just grab, you see these arrows that come up when I have a room selected. I can just grab one of these and adjust the size of the room there. You can see these objects came with it, so it's not destroying anything I've done.
That's beautiful.
If I want to get really crazy, I can make it really tiny, right? And then it gets rid of some of the objects.
They don't fit.
But I don't really want that. Get the, there we go. So let me just undo that.
There we go.
Let's pop that right back there. Okay, so that's a nice start for the bedroom. Let's start with the basics.
Okay.
Make sure my needs are met here. And you can see we have the same style.
I love this bathroom.
Yeah, this one's really cool.
Is so cool. You know what? Why don't we show people how you can actually pull objects straight out of this too?
Right.
I think I might even like this even better because I am terrible about interior design.
Right.
And being able to pull the objects and decor directly out of these rooms makes it so much easier to build. I actually used a lot of this when Graham and I were building the E3 demo.
I bet.
When we were building out the houses and different things like that. It makes it so easy. You can use these entire different rooms, but you can also create your own sizes and shapes with the blocks and
right.
then decorate them. And these will help you get a consistent style with consistent furniture
That's
all
exactly
throughout
it.
The rooms and dimensions that you have.
That's exactly it. So actually, you can see this, I'm highlighting stuff here. This is going to let me buy those individual things. Before I do that, let me actually build a little room here that I have somewhere to drop those into. So I'm just using our wall tool here, and then I'm going to draw out a room. There we go. And you can see it completes into a full room once I draw a completed shape. But now I have some space to put that stuff in.
Excellent.
So let me go back to our styled bathroom here. I could place this whole thing like we did before, but like Ryan was just saying, I can grab an individual object.
You can actually like grab the wallpaper and stuff too, right? Like
anything that's in there, yeah. That's yeah, so exactly. Cool. So let me get a bathroom down here, or a bathtub rather. I should mention, I don't have anything planned as to what we're going to build. So it's very off the cuff here. We'll see how the house comes out.
I think
out.
It's going to come together. Great.
Could have a sink, right? Let's try a different different color. I like this darker toilet.
The dark toilet.
I don't know why I like the dark toilet.
It's nice. It's a little out of the normal. I don't know if I've ever seen a
I've never gone to someone's house and
like
seen
that.
Yeah.
You know, I've seen a few solid gold toilets here and there, but never the black obsidian toilet.
Right. Exactly. It's definitely styling it up. This bathroom is huge.
It is massive.
So you know what? Let me just readjust that real quick. We'll pull this in.
There we go.
That's a
little bit more
fitting. This is a little better. We'll do that, and maybe rotate this here. If I pick it up, and I'm going to use hotkeys to rotate right now, so I can actually rotate while I'm moving it around. Let's do something more
like. I can't tell you how much I wanted this for blueprint mode in The Sims 3. I'm so happy we finally got it.
Oh man, it really changes the way that building feels. It just,
yeah.
I can't emphasize enough. Until you get hands-on with it, like you just,
right.
you don't really fully get it. It's pretty amazing. Let's get this floor here. You can't really tell because I need windows.
We're gonna need some light or some windows.
Yeah, let me get a light. Let me show off our search here. If I just say, wall lights. There we go. It comes up. I hit enter. It's going to take me right to wall lights. Let's grab this guy for now.
A little bit of light. We're going to need some wallpaper too on those nice metal.
Yeah, it's very walls. Very unfinished right now. I'm just going to drop a bunch of stuff down again. This is not premeditated building. So, let's get some wallpaper. Let's go grab a wall pattern here. You can see we have all these different types. I want to say show everything, and I'm looking for something. What's a good color for our bathroom wallpaper?
That's a good question. Why don't we go with orange?
Orange
bathroom.
It's kind of more of that southwestern feel. Yeah, keep consistent exactly. with that. Okay, so now we can see we're just looking at the orange stuff. All right, let's go. I like this kind of tiled thing. That feels kind of neat.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good choice.
I like that. Thank you. I agree.
You must have played with build mode before.
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
A little
yeah.
bit. And I actually want to get more of this. That's kind of too monochromatic
yeah, yeah.
there. So let me get rid of my filter here, And here, this one will look nice. I kind of want like a warm feeling bathroom.
Nice, some adobe bricks down there.
Yeah, exactly. So
the most important rooms right here.
Yeah, I mean, you could
bedroom and the bathroom.
This, well, kitchen also. Gotta have food.
God,
you can.
Good
your sim will be
good
happy
point.
For a little while with yep. this. So let's grab a kitchen.
Let's see.
Which. That's pretty nice. I always like the island counters.
Those are nice.
I like, let's see if one of these works.
Oh, that middle one kind of fit well with our style.
This
here.
One here?
Yeah, a little bit more
I like that.
Ranch style.
Yeah, definitely. Lots of wood there. Okay, so let me just come over here, and I think I'm going to have like a hallway kind of between this stuff, so I'll drop that down there. And then let's go back to the wall tool here, and we can start filling more of this in. So I'm going to hold the shift key, and I can drag out, rather than drawing individual walls, I can just drag out that rectangle there.
Nice.
And we need like a front door, I think. So let me grab that. So these here are different door heights. They correspond to the different wall heights.
Right.
So because the walls are super tall here, we can do a taller door.
Nice, I love that window above them.
Yeah, it's got this really modern look to
it. Right.
I like doing the combo Southwestern modern thing.
Yeah,
nice. It really fits
it's a good
in this
juxtaposition.
Right, I can just imagine myself living in this like swanky modern Southwestern house, looking out over that. I love it. But you know what? We need some wallpaper outside the house. I think.
Yes.
What do we want to go with? I'm thinking maybe
some kind of masonry. Or
masonry. I think maybe like we can always change this later. That's a little castle-y looking.
Yeah.
Let's look at some of these. Maybe siding's the best way to go. We'll start off with something kind of basic.
There we go.
We'll do this. So this is applying per room here.
You're holding a shift key.
Yeah, I'm holding the shift key, and it just paints the entire room. If you're not holding shift, you can still do individual tiles, right? But I don't want that. And we got this door on the back of the house. I don't need animals or people wandering into my kitchen in the middle of the night.
There's no door there. People are just going to come right in.
So let me,
smell the good cooking you got going on.
Exactly. So let me just shift that around there. There we go.
Perfect.
Okay, starting to come together. Let me. There we go. Better view.
I think we're going to need a foundation here, though.
You're right.
You know, we're out in the Southwest. You never know what varmints are going to be
or
running
scorpions
around.
Scorpions, coming in. I don't need any of that stuff.
No,
yeah, you
no.
don't need.
Let's
pop in some foundation. Okay, so I'll just go to the foundation section, and let me get a good angle so you can see this as it happens. So I'm just going to pop in some foundation, and it comes up right underneath the house, and we have 8 different levels that you can really like fine tune this. Let's start with that for now.
That's a good one. Keep the varmint. So you're going to have to fill me in here. I had a at length discussion with SimGuru Grant about whether it's varmint or varmint.
I say varmint.
I say varmint.
I think it's Yosemite Sam or something like that. Varmint.
SimGuru Grant is from Texas, so I imagine he knows.
Yeah, they have more.
Do any of you guys know? That's actually a good point to bring up. As we go, we're gonna hopefully take some of your guys' questions over here in the text chat over on the right side corner of your screen. We'll answer as much stuff as we can. If there's anything you'd like to see that we're not just showing right now, let us know too. So I'm gonna kind of turn my attention over here to watch what you guys are saying while Aaron continues building. So why don't you guys start off by telling us whether it's varmint or varmint?
I would love to know.
Yeah,
they can tell us.
I bet you woke up this morning just dying to know.
That was the first thing I thought of. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
A cool thing about these stairs here is that I can just drag them to be wider. I don't have to place multiple stairs. So I want that to be 2 stairs wide. Let's get some railings on here.
Oh, people want to see the auto placement windows too.
Oh, okay.
After you get the stairs going.
Perfect. Well, I'll just throw those in for now. Okay, so let me show you guys how this works. In fact, let's go up a floor here, and I'm just gonna quickly get a room out. So we'll do that.
Hold shift key down.
Yep, holding shift.
Nice.
And we can always adjust the size of it later. That's just so nice about it. I don't have to know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use our eyedropper here. And
perfect.
Yeah, sure. I'll just go with that for now. We can
Brick
adjust it later.
On the second floor, huh?
I like to do things a little differently.
Okay. All right.
You know,
build your own.
I can do whatever I want.
Okay, this is true.
You
this
don't
is your
lay your rules on me about brick on the second floor.
Okay.
But your edit is a little weird. Okay, so yeah, windows. So let's find a basic window here. Grab this guy, got some different colors. Sure, I like the darker window frame. So we have two different window placement ones. We got standard place one at a time. And if I go to this button here, I go into by room placement mode. And so now whatever room I mouse over, you can see the windows appear automatically spaced out around it. And with a single click,
nice.
Now I have windows and light in that room. And of course, I can still go in and adjust these and do whatever I want to.
I love
to,
how
but
you
it's,
can move them up and down the walls, too.
Oh, dude, it's placement. The best. Look at this. And if I hold the Alt key, I can even get smooth vertical
nice.
Placement, which is
cool.
Which is super cool. I'm gonna go a little wacky on this and just leave that guy here.
Excellent.
In fact, here, we'll do like a steps thing. Clone this guy. Here we go. And we'll just do something like this, because why not? All right, and just moving on up.
People are going crazy about the window thing. Yeah.
It's so it's good. Awesome. It's really awesome. So let me just, again, I'm just adjusting this here. I didn't know what I wanted as I built it, but we'll do this. Oh, check this out. This is something I love. So in our previous games, you had to have supports for stuff. You know, it would only let you drag out, I think it was like two tiles, right? And then it would tell you, oh, you need something under it.
Yeah.
And now I can just drag this all the way out and do these crazy cantilevered things.
Some crazy physics going on there.
And if I want to get really, really out there, I can drag this side over and we just have a floating room now because
excellent.
Why not?
Why not?
Exactly. Obviously, you'll still need stairs or something to get into it.
Crazy things happen in the Southwest, apparently.
That's right. It's yeah, exactly. And here's a quick little tip. If you want to make a floating room, well, this one's already floating, but you can place a room on top of itself to just move it up a floor and still have it be floating. It's a little
inside tip.
A little
right
inside
there
quick tip.
From the designer himself.
Right. But let me get that back there. And I actually want to keep this cantilevered for now.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Because I think that's kind of neat. I think maybe I'll play around with roofs a little bit.
Roofs, another part that I love about The Sims 4 build mode. These are so cool. Yeah, I think we've posted some rooms that some of our developers have actually built, some full houses with crazy looking roofs and stuff.
People
like
have
that.
Used them to make like pyramids and all this crazy stuff. It's really cool. And the reason you can do all this cool stuff is because of how customizable the roofs are. So like our rooms, I can resize them. I can drag them around. You already saw I adjust the height, the pitch of the roof, going to something a little realistic there. I can get the curves, I can curve it that way.
Nice.
I can do like cool pagoda stuff. It really lets you express
so
yourself through roofs.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And here's something I love.
Express yourself through roofs.
Well, yeah. So you can actually adjust the eaves, and you can see they both adjusted, both sides there. But if I want to adjust just one of them at a time, if I hold shift, now I'm only adjusting this one side. So again, lots of customization there. And actually, I want to get this kind of back out. There we go. I don't think I need the pagoda roof right here. And let me grab a texture.
Aaron, somebody on the chat over here, Mia Moisica, I believe you pronounce it, wants to marry the foundation tool.
She's
so deeply in love with it, or he, I can't tell. Miami Moisica, something like that.
It is super cool. Let me just show that again really quick.
Yeah.
So check this out. So these stairs here, as I raise the foundation, the stairs are going to adjust
nice.
In height, and they'll even get down to just this little landing thing.
That's so cool. Sims will actually just know to step right up onto that.
That's right.
Walk-in.
That's right. Exactly. So also, we didn't go over this when I was originally showing them off, but you can do different foundation styles, and these are applied per block also. You can see as I mouse over each one.
Cool. You just hold shift to cover the whole thing.
Well, actually, shift does a different thing with foundations. So foundations by default do the whole block, but this is something that's really cool you can do. Let me just pick one that looks pretty different. If I hold shift with foundation, it only applies to the side that you're pointing at. So you can, if you want to, it'd look pretty wacky, but you could do
just the individual sides.
You could do like a bunch of different foundation
crazy
types, right?
Crazy.
Yeah. so that it's nice and weird looking.
Yeah, exactly. We got a pretty eclectic looking house.
I want the neighbors to take notice.
Yes, exactly. Probably not in a good way either.
We'll come over and we'll throw a party and then smooth things
over.
There
we go.
Be cool.
I like it.
No homeowners fees or anything like that. Yeah.
Exactly.
All right. Let's see. What else do we want to get into here?
Anybody else is looking for over here?
Let me recolor this roof.
Oh, actually, people want to see kids' rooms.
Kids' rooms.
I know that we are only playing with your sim, Mr. Bachelor House here, but I think we're gonna need a kids' room.
All right. We should do kids' rooms. Let me quickly just get some coloring on these roofs. So you can do individual roof colors. I'll just leave those like that for now. Again, we're making kind of a Frankenstein house to demonstrate stuff. But okay, let's get some kids' rooms going. Let me drop the camera down. All right.
Never Grow Up X says, yay, kids' rooms.
I agree.
Yep. Never Grow Up wants to see the kids' rooms.
That makes sense. All right, so we'll go to kids' rooms here. And I'll just kind of click through each of these so you guys can see them all. We got this one's obviously for babies here. And we got some different colors. And here's another one. I love these toys. They're so cool. And the castle. Here we go. Here's another.
Aaron, there is like almost 10,000 people all typing at the same time over here.
That's
so hard. So exciting to see how many people are asking those questions. We'll try and get to all of them, but I can't promise we'll answer every one.
Yeah, I hope you're up on your speed reading practice.
Yeah, I know, right?
And one more kids' room here.
Nice.
Actually, I really like that one.
Oh, the dinosaur rug. Go to
the dinosaur? Yeah, what was that one? Oh, here? Yes, that is cool. Okay, let's grab this kids' room.
That's screaming Southwest.
And you know what? The kids' room is going to be upstairs.
Hey, and look, it automatically knows to place with that foundation and wall height, right? Because that's what you have set.
Yeah, with the foundation height and the wall height, it will automatically do that. So as you place
that's
it,
so cool.
It just snaps right in there. And, like foundation height, you can adjust wall height on the fly, and you can see that everything adjusts with it. Yeah. Actually, there we go. Okay, let us drop the camera down and move this door so that the kids can get into the room.
Yes.
That's an important part.
The key.
There we go. And let me just zoom in so you guys can check this out.
Yeah. Oh, there's the playhouse and the ginormous stuffed animal there.
Yeah, I love the stuffed animal. Now, one cool thing you can do, if you use the G key, I do this when it toggles the grid on and off. So if I want to like zoom in and kind of check out the details of what's going on, I'll turn that off for a little bit. Oh, that's cool.
It's a good looking room.
It is a good looking room. It's going to turn into a good looking house. You know what? I want these to kind of be different colors, I think. So I'm going to grab our design tool here, and I'm just going to click on that bed and see what other options we have available. Right now it has the blue. There we go.
Nice. That's the one.
Just a little more variation. Okay, it still has the dinosaur theme.
It matches the stuffed animal over
there
in the corner.
Exactly. Okay.
All right. You know what? I think we need to show people some of those career reward rooms.
The career reward rooms?
So okay. So this is actually a brand new copy of the game, so we haven't unlocked any of this, but we want to give you guys a little sample of some of the great things you can actually earn by playing through the careers.
Right.
So you can actually unlock some of these really amazing styled rooms that all fit into the different careers that you can play in the game.
Exactly. So you can see these are locked right now. Once you reach level 10, you unlock these items along the way. Once you've unlocked them all, you can place the whole room. So here's our kitchen. This looks like something out of like a cooking show on TV or something. I can
absolutely.
Just totally see you cooking some gourmet stuff there.
Right there.
Yeah.
Totally.
Here's newsroom. Our newsroom. Sit and relax in that chair.
Yes.
And just, yeah. This is our artist room.
I like it. You know what? Let's not give all of them away. We want to save a little surprise and intrigue for next week. But needless to say, there's some really cool stuff in here.
Definitely. It's going to be a lot of fun playing. It feels so good to like progress in your career enough to finally get that room in place. And you're like, yes,
really cool
this is made
stuff.
For me. Okay, I need some carpeting or something in this. So I'm just going to do that real quick. Let's grab some carpet. Oh, I just kind of like this red carpet. Go and let's get some wallpapering going on out in the hallway. Again, I'm using our our eyedropper tool. I'm using hotkeys to get to it. That's why you guys don't see me clicking on the stuff up here. All right. If I open our lot info panel here, I can see how much of the lot costs. Excellent. From what I've built so far. So that's kind of cool. And I can rename it and stuff like that.
Set the number of beds and bathrooms.
Yeah, exactly. So this info is used when you share stuff up on the gallery.
Right. You can also change the lot types too, right? You can set your lots to be different venues, and it's actually cool when you set your lot to be a different lot type, like a specific venue. It will actually tell you the specific objects you need to place on that lot so that the venue is fully functional for all the great things that you can do in gameplay, and see you later this week.
Yeah, it's super cool. Yeah, you can't change it when a sim is living there, so you'd have to go to an empty lot.
Yeah.
But I'm sure we'll show that off.
Or evict your sim. And
or just, yeah, kick the sim out and say, deal with it. I'm going to change this to to be a library. Because.
Why not?
Okay.
I've seen some people asking, they want to see us build some stairs up to the next story, because right now nobody else can get to that top room.
You're right. We have this huge empty space, cantilevered room. Let me bump up those wall heights there. But we need a way to get up there.
Yep.
So there's a couple ways that you can connect stairs. You know, we could do it from inside the house, but let me just show off a couple of the ways we can do this. Let me turn the grid back on. Okay, so if I grab some stairs, I'm gonna grab these guys. These are a lot more flexible than in past games. You see, I can just connect. Let me get the camera angle right. I can connect right up to the side there. I can rotate these around to connect that way. I can actually. Get this. Here we go. I can go underneath.
Nice.
Just from the terrain, straight up into that room.
It knows how high the walls are, how high the foundation is, and
that's right. Exactly.
It's specific.
Again, if I drop these wall heights down, you see those stairs stay there.
Excellent.
It's super cool. I'm building. Like I said, unorthodox building. This is how you get to this room. You got to go outside.
Yep.
And this is kind of unwieldy as a big room here. So let me just draw a wall and split this into two separate rooms.
I think one of these needs to be our living room. Get some cool entertainment features in here.
I think you're right. Let me get some more windows on here, and I'm just going to stay in window placement mode to quickly click of a button get that to happen. Let me use the sledgehammer.
People want to know if you can adjust the stair width.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Let me knock out these walls real quick. So there we go. So I don't want a doorway there. I just want to do that. But if I grab these stairs, let me get a nice view here. And if I just adjust that, there we go.
Nice.
Yeah, it's super. So you're not placing like multiple stairs. You just do the one.
Just drag them out just like you would with a room wall.
Exactly. Everything is just push and pull and readjust.
Tactile.
And
intuitive.
It's very tactile.
Exactly.
It's very intuitive. But it is. It really is. Okay. Let's see here. I think we need some railings on here.
Yeah, the stairs are give you some good altitude. I think you're going to want some protection.
We're going to go with these glass railings. So like I said, I want swanky on my house.
You got that modern Southwestern juxtaposition going.
Well, there. I mean, if you look at what I'm building here, I don't know if you can call this modern anymore. This is more.
There's definitely some juxtaposition.
It's like ultra modern.
Yeah.
It's setting the new trends.
It's so far past anything anybody would expect.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Nice.
And of course, we'll have to get some fitting Sims to live here that no one would expect also. But let's build our living room here and let me start putting that together. So of course, we have our styled rooms, but let me hop into our other object catalogs here. So of course, we have by room and by function, but I'm going to hop over to the living room sort. And what do I want to figure out first? I think TV placement's pretty
Blue
important.
Blue Knight X says we've created a monster house.
I have to agree. So I want a wall-mounted TV. So let me just drag this here. I'm going to put it right between those windows, and I'm going to move those to the sides there a little bit. Okay, so here's my TV. Height adjustable. I'll leave it in line with the windows for now. And let's grab a couch now. This guy's kind of a cool Southwestern love seat. Look at all these different variations we have. Sure, I'm going to go super bright for now and just see what develops as we build this thing. And the floor is feeling a little bare, so let me get in some tiling. I like this. No, you know, living room should be a little more plush. I'm gonna go with the red carpet again. Here we go. And here's a cool feature, actually. If I want to do some accents, we have this in Sims 3 also. But if I do, I think it's F. Yeah, here we go. Control F. So then I can go do quarter tile placement, and I can do, you know, I can put in little patterns. Nice. And we won't spend the time during this broadcast to really do something, but you can put some really cool stuff together doing that. Yeah.
One of my most favorite things, you guys have heard me say this before, is when we launch a game, seeing what you guys build and create. We've already seen it in Create a Sim, you guys building wild, amazing looking Sims that we never expected. And Build Mode is going to be much more of that, I would imagine.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. People are going to be able to go nuts with this. And sharing it on the gallery with everyone. Okay, I need some like modern wallpaper or something here. We have. How about it? You know, if we're going with the monster house, let's just take
electric
this all the way.
Electric sheepskin, is that what this is called?
Yes.
Yeah, excellent.
Electric sheepskin. Yeah. That's right. And we need some lighting in here. It's getting a little dark. So let me just search for that again. I do. I want ceiling lights. Ceiling lamps. There we go. What kind do
let's
we like?
Let's get some modern.
Let's go with like one of these guys.
Yeah, there we go.
I kind of like these.
Yep. Feel perfect with the electric sheepskin.
Yeah, it will. So I have red and green. Let's get some blue out here also.
Oh,
just
monster
really
monster house.
Yes,
we're coming to life. Right?
We got to embrace it.
Yep.
You know, if you find out that's what you're building, you just got to go
just
with
dive
it.
Dive in with it.
Yeah. Okay. So that's enough lighting for now, just to get it so it looks well lit up while we're building.
So we've got that amazing flat screen up there, but
we do.
A user on here named Sikoa Grace, I believe is how you pronounce it. Happened to see the freezer bunny or the penguin TV.
Oh,
me, the penguin
okay.
TV.
Okay. Well, let's go to TVs. And let me hop over to. There we go.
There we go.
This guy.
Yes.
We're going to need a stand for this. Well, I guess you could watch it on the ground, but it's going to make my Sims' necks hurt.
Right.
I don't want that.
Obviously.
Okay, so let's get a little accent table to put this on. Let's get a nice stand. And I'm going to put it, like, maybe just right underneath the other TV. Oh, okay, so check this out. This is another thing I want to show off. If you hit F5, you can see right now we're doing, like, half-grid placement.
Right.
We can go to quarter-grid if you hit F5.
Cool.
So that's really sweet. And, of course, if I hold Alt, I can do free placement.
Free placement.
But I'm going to leave it on Snap for now.
F5 lets you stay in that grid, but gives you a little bit more flexibility.
Exactly, exactly.
Nice.
All right, so let's get that Penguin TV up.
Penguin Vision Children's Television Set.
I think I want an orange penguin. There we go.
Monster house.
Yeah, well, so now I can watch twice the TV. I can just...
Right.
You know, you really live it in luxury when you have a penguin TV right below your big
flat
screen.
Exactly.
All right. What else do we need in a living room? What do people want to see in the living room?
What do you guys want to see in the living room? Let's...
put some blinds
up. Why don't we ask the people?
Yeah. Get some shades over here. Do something like that. I don't need reflections on my TV, so we'll put these on.
Penguin TV.
It's the best TV.
Yeah. People want to see the gaming rig. They think that needs to be in a living room here.
Okay. I am not going to argue with anyone who wants gaming.
Rig.
Okay, there we see it. Motion gaming rig. Let's go right there.
Excellent.
And I like color customizing everything. So okay, let's put this down.
Fun for our Sims, right
in this
there.
Corner
they
over
figure
here.
Figure out how to make it up to this room, of course.
Well, let's get my Sim up there actually, really quick.
Let's do it.
Let's get him up there because there's some other stuff I want to show off. So okay, so he's he's over here. So head on up there, Sim me.
Looks like he's got quite a few other interactions queued up there.
Oh, he does. We've kind of left him. There we go. All right, get up there.
You guys wanted to see live mode. Here you go, off the script.
There is no script. Should I?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Yep.
Let's hop in. Let's check it out. Let me go.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Stack those blocks.
I like it. Oh, you're in speed 2.
Oh yeah. Let me slow down just a little bit
here.
There we go. All right. Got some blocks.
Nice.
It's dodging. I hope he doesn't get hit in the head.
You never know.
So yeah, this is our motion gaming rig.
I'm gonna play some blocks there. There we go. Oh. Playing with the motions. We got our tutorial up on screen right now. You guys will get to play through it as soon as you get into live mode.
So much new stuff. It's good tips and tricks for. Yes. Oh, my sim wants to cook. Okay, well, we'll do that in a sec. Excellent. I want to show you guys. Yes, the lot info panel.
Right there.
This is yeah we were talking about earlier. Great way to check out your lots. Okay, so check this out. I can actually just like move this out from under my sim. Like he's using it, right?
Yeah.
And it's gonna reset him.
That's so cool.
So you don't have to do that like toggle back and forth between live mode and build mode.
In the past where your sim would walk into the room and you'd go
and you're like, no, I'm trying to build.
Exactly.
Please. In fact, if I really want to get crazy, I can just delete the entire room out from under him. You see he falls down
it's
to the ground.
Oh, where'd my room go?
Yeah, I'm sure it would be very confusing living in a world where parts of your house just disappear. And move around.
Exactly.
And actually, speaking of moving around, let me show one other cool thing here. I can just move this whole house. If I decide that, you know, maybe this isn't quite where I wanted it to be, I can pick up the entire thing. And let's, now that we know, we have a little more of the structure developed, let's move it up here.
That's so cool.
And we'll just move that right there.
So people are clamoring to see some landscaping.
Landscaping, okay.
See some of the outdoor stuff we can place down, so.
It's so dry and sandy out here.
Yeah.
I think that walking in the door, I don't want to, well, there's no door for one. Let me get my front door back out there real quick. Probably when I was, I adjusted the wall height, and so it got rid of the door for me. That's what happened. Okay, let me quickly, there we go, get my door back.
Nice.
Okay, but yeah, as I'm coming in that front door, you know, I think maybe some grass would be better, just so we're not tracking sand into the house and everything. So here we have, you know, an eraser. You can paint all the different sizes. You guys know the drill. So I'm going to grab this large one, and I'm using hotkeys to adjust the feathering here, so I just want it to be pretty solid. And let's put in a nice lawn right out front.
It's going to be an expensive lawn to maintain here in the desert.
Yeah, it will. This isn't actually the most environmentally friendly thing I'm doing, I guess. But, I don't know.
Maybe we'll just call it turf, and we'll pretend that it is...
Yes, it is turf. Exactly. That's what we'll tell the neighbors, at least.
Exactly.
So let me get my turf in here. Okay, so we got that, and then you know, I want a little bit of flowers in here, but let's do this a little more subtly. If I get these to be, just kind of like get some of this in.
We can also place down trees and plants as well, right?
Oh, absolutely.
We don't have to paint all the flowers down here.
No.
A good selection.
We have lots of stuff, Sarah. So we got trees, shrubs, flowers, rocks, and everything. So I actually always like getting some, I like these this lavender. Let me just zoom in here so we can see this a little better. And I'm going to line the front here with some lavender.
Very nice.
Get a couple of those out there.
Ooh, what is that?
Maybe these guys. Yeah. Let me zoom in on this because the detail is pretty cool. So if we check this out.
Nice.
And maybe I want to try a different flower color.
That's so awesome.
Make that yeah, exactly. So you can.
It'd be so cool if you could do that in real life.
Right?
Just like,
plant it.
I want the flowers out front today to be pink.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, that's the thing about build mode, is you just start slapping stuff down, and then it's really easy to change it to whatever
There's no mistakes, like it needs to be.
You
can just, if you want a different look, a different shape, you just
change it.
Yep.
You don't have to delete. Right. That's actually something that a lot of us had to get used to as we started playing with Sims 4 build, coming from Sims 3. You have this, when you do something like wrong, then you're like, oh, I got to delete it and rebuild. And you're like, well, wait a sec, I don't have to delete it.
That was always the thing for me, too, is I'd start building something in other Sims games, and I'd be like, oh, I made a beautiful house, but I forgot the foundation, and it looks off. And you'd have to go back and delete everything and then replace it on top of the foundation. But now you just have that foundation control, and up and down you go.
Exactly, exactly. Let's get this little llama guy out here. I want him greeting people. As they come to my house.
Okay, well, let's put the elephant down, too.
Here we go.
Perfect.
These are my sentinels outside of my my front door here. What else do we have? We have trees. I love these palm trees. This guy's really cool. Kind of rotate this around. Let's...
Llama. Everybody's going crazy about the llama.
The llama's awesome.
Yeah.
So lots of different tree types. Let's do some bamboo around my palm tree. I'm gonna get like some kind of tropical bamboo palm tree thing going on. I don't know what I'm making.
No. It's an eclectic house.
It's an eclectic house for an eclectic sim. And get this big pink tree over here. Let's check that out. I love just zooming in and checking out the details. That palm tree is so cool. Okay.
People are asking about what happens when you don't pay your bills, and this is actually one of my favorite things.
This is great.
There was the repo man in The Sims 3, and he'd come and steal your stuff. Right. But if, for instance, in The Sims 4, you don't pay your electric bill, long enough time goes by and boom.
We'll cut your power.
Power goes out.
And in fact, I forget which one happens first, but we'll cut your power and we'll cut your water.
That's right.
As like, it's like if you still continue not to pay, we'll just cut it all out. You can keep living there, but you're gonna have a hard time.
Yeah, that's gonna be a challenge.
So this is actually something people have asked about: is you can just go ahead and place trees. Like if I want this tree growing out of my roof of my house,
why not?
I'm gonna go for it. And you can do cool stuff. I think we have some grass here. So I could actually fill that in and be like, you know what, I have like a rooftop lawn.
Yeah, a roof on like a skyscraper in a city or something like
exactly,
that.
But exactly.
Here in the Southwest.
And I'll grab a fence here. And I'll go into draw a fence. I just want this guy up around the edge of this roof. Here we go. Do something like this. Here we go. Oh, so that became a block. What happened there is it replaced the floor that I had before because I completed a block. So a new block came in. So I'll just go grab
putting
that.
The fences there.
Yeah, exactly. Because I drew the fence all the way around. But we'll just put that right back in. And then.
So you could then like pick up that block, right, and move it around.
That's right. This is actually a thing that I could I can grab and like if I want to move this down here for some reason. There it is. But I don't want that down there. That's a little too weird even for my house.
Yep.
But I do need a door to get out there, so let's grab one of these. I'm a big fan of these glass doors.
Let's the light in.
And oh, I gotta get this window out of the way here. Let me just here we go. Yeah, exactly. You get some nice natural lighting. There we go. So now I've got my little rooftop tree garden area thing.
Dang.
Yeah, exactly. I kind of want to get some fountains.
Gotta get
in here.
Some fountains.
Yeah,
we got to place some of those water jets too. I was playing around with those while I was setting up.
Those things are cool.
Those are really fun.
So I'm gonna do just a fountain along the side of my house here.
Perhaps a moat. We can call it a moat.
We can do I'll do a nice long fountain there. And so there we go. I have that. Just to offset the desert heat a little
varmints.
Bit.
The varmints out.
Exactly. And I can drop a trim down here on the fountain. Let's stick with this red one. Oops. There we go. Okay, so we wanted to see the water jets. So let me do that real quick. And actually, let me just come over and experiment here. Because I want to show you this. I love the jumping water jets. So let me grab this one, and we're going to go with red. Okay,
so you can change the color of the spouts too. That's awesome.
Yeah, it actually changed. I'll get a couple of these out so we can check this out. Let's do this double dome. Yeah, and let's do a
really class up the place here with the fountain.
Yeah, exactly. I mean. This fountain's a little weird, but absolutely you can build like cool reflecting ponds.
What
in the front.
Isn't about our lot here?
You can tell that I kind of like to play weird things in The Sims. That's what I'm into.
Yep.
But let me just hop over to live mode for just a sec so that the fountains will start up. And I love this guy. It's
go.
This little leaping. I love this thing.
Excellent.
So yeah, I think that's really cool. And you can see this is our green fountain.
Oh, the water's even the color of the fountains too.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
And at night, it will actually change up there's lighting. So if you have a colored one, it'll kind of glow green and stuff like that.
You can actually click into night mode there, right?
Right. So let me shift into nighttime.
Look at your lot and all the different times of days. Oh, it's beautiful.
Right. So you can see it's dealing with this cool lighting stuff.
Feels very Burning Man-esque, would you say?
With all the glowing, the glowing hopping
the glow
lights.
Sticks,
absolutely.
Exactly. I wonder if anybody's watching from Burning Man right now.
They'd have to be pretty hardcore to tune in. Yeah.
From
Brooklyn. I wonder.
Do they have internet out there?
They do. They do now. They have, like, everything out there.
They got high tech.
There's, like, CEOs of companies that go out there with millions of dollars and set stuff up. It's pretty crazy. But let me just get a kind of this wider view so you can see cycling through the different times. So this isn't actually changing the game time, but it's letting me, while I'm building, scope out how my house is going to look. And I can see how the light's going to come in through the windows and stuff like that. So far, I've only been doing, I wanted to show this off. There's so many things to show. We're gonna run out of time eventually to show everything here, but
I think we got about 10 minutes left.
Okay, good to know. So,
somebody just said they're at Burning Man. Richard,
they are.
Richosaurus XX.
Sweet, that's awesome. That's way cool. We're people tuning in from the middle of the desert.
It's almost like we're at Burning Man right now.
That's right. If I place some more glowing lights everywhere,
right?
So far we've showed off all of our rectangular rooms. Like, that's all I've been drawing. It's kind of the easiest thing to do, but I just want to show off here. So what I'm doing is I'm just going to draw a custom room shape. So you can see I'm drawing totally non-rectangular. It's just kind of like weird room. Again, going with the theme of the house. But as I connect this final piece, it's going to turn into
a block.
Yeah, exactly. So cool. Exactly. So then I can move that around. So you're not just stuck with the pre-made shapes, right, or anything. You can really just do crazy stuff if you want.
That's awesome.
So I'll turn that into an artist studio later or something.
So you know what? With our remaining time, why don't we take a little bit of a look at the gallery? Because there's some really cool things that I actually, when I went from The Sims 3 to The Sims 4, I didn't expect us to have, like the ability to not just upload this whole house, but we can actually share just one of the rooms, right?
Right. Let me find a room here. And this is something I think people are going to love. Let me connect this guy.
And so I think what we'll do is we'll actually share some of this stuff too, and then when you guys get the game next week, you can grab this exact lot from this very demo and then play with it at your house.
And maybe turn it into something a little more livable.
Right, exactly.
Okay, so the way you share an individual room is you select that room, and then you're going to go up to the Save to My Library, right? And we have two options here. One saves the entire lot, which is totally cool, but the other will save a room if you have it selected. And so this is going to pop up. You can see the room here. And by clicking here, I can select which camera angle I want to display for the room. I think this one kind of lets you see in the best.
You can see the Penguin TV, most importantly.
Right. I mean, that's the major selling point of the room. Right. And this is a living room, so we'll call it that. If you fill this stuff out, it's going to help people find it in the gallery.
Right.
And we'll just say...
this is the living room from Ryan and Aaron's demo.
Living room from First Sims 4 Let's Play.
Excellent.
All right. Okay. So there we go. And then I can just say share room to the gallery. I can also just save it locally if I don't want to share it.
Right.
If I wanted to like keep working on it or something, or just use it on one of my other lots.
Right. You don't have to share it to the gallery. You can actually
just save it locally if you want.
And then you could use it whenever you want.
Yeah. It's super useful, but much more fun to share my creation with the world. So I'll, I got to name it. I got to name it up here too. Let's call it Weird. I can't spell.
Living room.
Living room.
Sounds like a Polish word or something.
Likving.
You guys have likving rooms in Poland?
All right. And there's my room size. Here's how much it's going to cost. People want to build it. And then I will upload this to the gallery.
And just like that, there we go. We get the message over here, the TNS.
Message here. This is green because it shows I've saved it.
And if we were logged into Facebook, just like you can in the Create a Sim demo, you can actually share and post your creation to Facebook so people can see it.
Yeah, it's really cool because you want to get the word out there about the cool stuff you're making. So let me open up the gallery here. Yeah.
And the best way for you guys to find this when you log in a week is to search for our username that we're using, which is TS4 Livestream. So you'll be able to find all the content that we upload over the next couple weeks by searching for that origin username. And hey, there we go. There's the room.
So there's my room. Let me get that out of the way there. We only have this one shared item right now, but we're gonna upload
first
a bunch of cool stuff.
In the can.
First one.
I like it.
What an honor. All right.
There you go.
So there we go. So then I can, of course, place my own room that I built if I want to like have a copy of it. And let me just make sure it fits in here. There we go.
Oh, the stairs stay too. I totally yep. thought they were going to be deleted.
No, if you line it up, that's like, awesome. Yeah, the stairs are there. And I have this weird kind of like room inside of a room, but I can always, you know, adjust this.
There we go. Push it up to the walls.
Yeah.
Now you have exactly. almost kind of clone the room here, right? You have back to back.
Totally.
Weird living room.
Exactly.
The living room.
The living room. Cloned and repurposed. There we go. Let's make sure you can get between them.
You know, while we're at it and talking about the gallery, we yeah. probably should upload the whole lot too.
Absolutely. So again, you can go here, and now I don't have a room selected, so it doesn't let me do that. But I just say save the lot, and it gives me a nice shot here. And there's we generated. This is such a weird house. but we got some different angles, the different floors, and everything, so you can see what's going on. And here, what do we have? We only had one bedroom.
No, there's the kids' room too.
Oh, the kids' room. Yes, that's right. Okay, so two bedroom. There's no, we have a two living room, but there's right. not a setting for that. Exactly. We only have the one bathroom in there right now. And this is the whole weird house.
I like it.
And we'll call it Weird House Number One. Where's the, why can't I find the pound
the
sign?
Number three.
Oh, there we go. This is an odd keyboard. Okay. Weird House One. There we
there
go.
We go.
Okay, and let's upload this. Maybe someone can turn this into something a little more livable. I hope so.
Exactly. You guys have been doing some cool challenges with your Sims, changing them to look like something different. Maybe you guys can use this lot and build it into something that is actually somewhat decent.
That'd be a fun challenge. Like, take this and try and turn it into something that works.
Exactly. Oh, and also worth noting, too, as soon as you guys upload a lot or a house or even a Sim, it will automatically save to your local file.
That's right, yeah.
So you can see down in the bottom right-hand corner there, it's actually already saved.
Already
so
saved.
Just one click. It's really nice.
And one cool thing about when you save rooms is that you can get them to appear. If I open up the gallery here, and we'll go to the stuff that we've uploaded. Here you can see the weird house and the weird room. So I can take this room and put it into my you can get it to appear down in your catalog, so you can have your own catalog of style rooms.
Got it.
Yeah, it's really useful. I'm excited actually for people to build an entire house and then save the individual rooms out and upload those. So then I can build a house with their rooms that's like, it's like their house but rearranged.
Right.
I think there'll be some
really
cool
stuff. If you
have
different sized lots or something like that too, it would work well. You could mix and match the different rooms that you want.
Exactly.
Beautiful.
Exactly.
Let's jump back in the gallery too, because I know a lot of Simmers who were actually out here for Creator Camp actually built a lot of stuff and uploaded it, I believe. So why don't we take a little tour around the gallery right now, just see what we can find. There's tons of Sims up here from you guys. Why don't we go to the All Sort too? We're on Maxis.
Oh, okay,
right now.
Okay. There we go. So we'll go to all.
Yep. And see what kind of lots. There we go.
Okay. So this is a couple things that
Sim Guru Graham uploaded.
Let's check this out.
Mary's Place.
Edna and Mary's
let's put
place.
This down on our lot. Let's just nuke what we've done now that we've got it saved.
This is cool looking. I agree. And look at, he wrote this like nice little thing about
Sim
it.
Mode rewards fans of The Sims.
Okay. So I'm going to just bring that into build mode. We want it furnished.
Yep.
And it's letting me know it's going to replace the entire lot. So we'll just drop that straight in. Quick little load here. We didn't have access because this is a new game to some of the stuff that was in the house.
Right. He used some of the reward, the Plumbob lights, I believe, for people that have some of the Sims 3 games entitled. You get these reward lamps, I believe.
Exactly. And the same thing would happen if you had like career unlocks in a house, but you hadn't earned them in your game yet. We let you place the house, and we just remove a couple of those things and let you know about it. So let's take a gander around a house that actually looks
Graham's
like it was
awesome
built for people
builder.
To live in.
Look at
he is.
Yeah, he put this house together a little bit more cohesively than the house.
I think he had some time to like sit and do it without a bunch of people watching him.
About 10,395,000 people watching.
Yes, exactly. So let's do. Let me just toggle the grid off here, and we'll just do a quick little fly through of this house. I love the look at the. Check this out. This is really cool.
I wonder if Graham's watching right now. He's actually down in Australia. In Sydney,
down under.
I think. Yeah, he's down under doing some demos for people down there. So if you're watching, hey, Graham.
I love the being able to add clutter like this to the house. It just really
dirty
makes it look
laundry.
Lived in, right?
Yep.
Look at this little cool like spice rack thing. I love this. What a cool looking house. Yeah, this looks much more comfy than mine.
Aaron, do you know how to use the size cheat, the resize cheat?
I do.
There's lots of people asking for us to show it. We've got 2 minutes left. I think this is probably the best way. This is kind of a wild thing. It's a cheat, so it we might break some things here. I'm not quite sure.
No guarantees.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so I think what we need is a giant bowl of fruit. So let me. The size cheat is.
Oh, you just got bigger.
Oh, it did? Okay, just take a sec. Okay. Yeah. Oh, that's right. You have to like move it. Okay, right. That's right. Yeah. So
that is a ginormous bowl of fruit.
Oh, you don't even know yet. We're really just gonna go crazy with this, and because
it's the bowl of fruit monument.
Nothing says luxury like a giant bowl of fruit in your backyard.
That is amazing.
So I think
cheat works on just about every object, right?
Yeah, it does. It does. I mean, your Sims, like if I made the couch huge, your Sims aren't going to be able to sit on it or anything. But you can do some really cool sculptural and creative stuff with that. Here's a fun one, actually. Let me... Okay, I'm searching for the elephant.
Let's be awesome.
Let's get this guy. There. I don't think anyone's going to want to mess with me if I have this giant elephant hedge.
Nobody's coming up to your little humble house here on the cliffs.
No, that's right.
That is awesome.
Imagine how that would look from
afar.
From the neighbor's, the neighbor's house.
Nobody's coming up here. That is awesome. Well, you know what? I think we're just almost out of time. We thank you guys so much for tuning in. We've had a lot of fun playing today. We're going to keep broadcasting. Other gurus are going to be on, other developers, producers, and designers are going to be here. Same sim time, same sim channel. We really love having you guys on. We cannot wait for you guys to get this game into your hands. It's so exciting for us. Everybody around the studio is buzzing right now. We're all cannot wait for you guys to start playing. So if you guys have more questions, you know we're on Twitter. SimGuru Ryan and SimGuru Houts, Houts, I believe.
That's it. You got it.
Exactly. Nice. We're on there as much as we can be. We love answering your questions, so please tweet us, and we'll try and tweet back as much as we can. So thank you guys for tuning in. We loved playing with you today, and we look forward to seeing you guys tomorrow. So thanks so much, and we will see you again soon. Bye, guys. Awesome.